Hello, this is Matt Cutts, and we brought back Othar from the Search Quality Group, who's one of the main guys who's been working on rel equals author and authorship, and we wanted to talk a little bit about a way to make it even easier to annotate your pages and show that there's authorship. So Othar, we've done a video in the past where we walked through, you know, you just add rel equals author to an anchor that's basically pointing to a Google profile or a bio page.
Right.
It's not that hard to edit the HTML, but some people are kind of allergic to editing their HTML, or you know, they can't get their CMS guy to do anything at all.
So, or they have a sanitizer in the way that's just stripping out the rel equals.
So is there anything that's Google can do that's even easier as a way to, you know, show this is the person who created this content?
Of course there is.
Wow, tell me all about it.
So I'd like to talk about using basically special anchors and special URLs. Mm-hmm. To get around this problem that not every author can change their site and add rel equals author tags. So here's how you do it. Find your Google profile. Right? Mm-hmm. It has some URL, mm-hmm. right? Since we're handling the case where you can't add, you know, rel equals author to the link, mm-hmm. we want you to add basically a CGI param at the end of your link, mm-hmm. question mark, rel equals author, just on the end of that link, right?
Okay.
Wrap that in an A tag, uh-huh. right? So href equals uh-huh. that. And also, just we want to make sure that we don't, like, unintentionally, you know, say that you're the author of some article. Uh-huh. We want you to put as the anchor of that article something like, you know, plus Matt uh-huh. Cutts.
Okay.
Cool. Right, and then close the tag. Right.
Uh-huh. So if I can't control the, you know, the attributes, I can still add a link to this special URL. I just add question mark rel equals author, and then I add the plus because Google plus and, you know, all that sort of stuff. So the anchor text is saying Matt Cutts wrote this, and I'm pointing to my Google profile.
Right. Okay. And so as always, you want to point back to the site that you're writing on. But but this makes it a lot easier. And when you see these plus, you know, name links on the web.
It's a pretty common idiom now. People
view source, check out whether they're doing this uh-huh. idiom. Uh-huh. And again, this gets to the problem that not every author can change their site and add rel equals tags everywhere they want.
This is fast. Like, I can take anything that's already you know, hyperlinked up. I don't have to change my CMS. I just add this one extra parameter. I add a plus in front of the
exactly. name. And you can just add it like in the footer of the article you just wrote. Mm-hmm. You can say, you know, read the full interview at X and, you know, visit me on Google Plus at this link.
Okay, well, that seems really simple. Do we still want people to do the full markup if they can?
So we still do, because that's a lot more, you know, bulletproof, right?
Yeah.
It's we're not going to unintentionally give you credit for things that you didn't write.
Okay.
So we still want people to do that, but this is a good interim measure
to
get the data. In the meantime,
I like it a lot. Short and simple. All you have to do is add a hyperlink. You don't even have to edit your HTML at all.
Right. And so, as always, visit the Google Authorship Help Center for full details on this.
Awesome.
You know, syntax may change. Who knows? But
yeah, everything can evolve in the future. And we'll add a link in the metadata for the video. So if you're watching this on YouTube, click down and look at the other stuff, and you'll find a link to the help and all the documentation about it. All right, great. Thanks very much.
Thanks.